that scrolls become very, very protective.
Okay.
Yes. Very protective.
It's amazing, isn't it?
Right.
You design your own erotic banner as well, don't you?
Oh. Well, this was sad when we were in the show before.
Oh, so
it's
interrupt your
tools. So,
saw the tomb of the markers for unpopular kings and queens, which were the white tiles, very plain and simple. Not that they were popular, but they intended to be. King Henry VII and Elizabeth of York. Henry VII had the Lady Chapel here built, basically as a very lavish mausoleum for himself and his family. But he was a very mean man, a parsimonious man usually, so people were very shocked that he lavished this much money on himself, or on anything really. See all the heraldic beasts. fair, fine photograph. And here's an interesting thing, look. This is the burial place of Oliver Cromwell, where he was buried until they pulled him out of his grave, put his body on trial, and executed a dead body for high treason. So that showed him, didn't it? Sorry. The Royal Air Force Chapel, this is. Second. He wanted revenge, and part of that revenge was having Cromwell's body pulled out of its tomb in here. So he was only buried for a few years, really, and then he was pulled out, the body was put on trial. Samuel Pepys's wife went and paid sixpence to go and look at the body in its coffin, but Samuel Pepys didn't agree with that, so he didn't go and do it, but... Henry VII. It was their marriage that ended the War of the Roses. Because you had Lancaster against York and Plantagenet, and it was a nasty business. And as I said, it was a very messed up dynasty. Because, when Richard III took supposedly killed his nephews, and he took the throne. The rumour and story is that his own niece, Elizabeth of York, who lays here next to her actual husband, was going to marry him, her own uncle, to secure the throne. That's how ruthless the royals were in those days, because you had Edward, Elizabeth's father, and Elizabeth Woodville, who some called a witch and whatnot, and that. They were very ruthless. So, yeah. This is the King, this is King James the Second, is it? IR. Which is, yeah. I think it's King James, I could be wrong. Most on my Lord of the behalf, still hold us south side. So, if you're in the most honourable order of the bath, this is where you sit and this is where your badges are put. Something to do with the Collegiate College. Died in March the 14th, 1669. Dynasty, and he needed to kick that off and make it look glorious and noble and right. And this is part of that process. Even in the inland, I'll spend money on what he has to. It's an extremely impressive sniff back, wasn't it? These originally, years ago, were for monks to rest on. So they didn't actually sit down, but they could take the weight off their feet of it for hours and hours of prayer.
Is it direct descendant of Arabs? It just happens to have been, when we went to the Germans, because they were cousins, they went back to her as well. That's kind of interesting. And one last thing, is you remember I said there's no saint of veneration in the Church of England. See, can you swear all these banners up in the word of angels?
Look at the as I said, the unpopular one's got time. This. This is the grandson of King Henry VII, Henry VIII's son. And some say that it isn't even his real body that's here. It's a long story that the Lord involved in when he was ill. He died of TB, and there's rumours that the great lord wanted him to live longer, so he was given small amounts of arsenic to keep him alive. Obviously, when he did die, that body needed to be got rid of, because even then they could tell with arsenic. So the body of a murdered Deptford apprentice, embalmed beyond recognition, was sealed in lead and buried here. So the story goes. Francis Brandon, who we've already spoken about and seen her tomb, she came out with that story in the reign of Queen Mary. She was trying to save herself. And Mary did not want the matter looked into. The Lady Chapel, and you've got, looking here, Henry V, one of England's greatest kings, and behind him is the shrine to St. Edward the Confessor through there. So you're looking at one of the greatest kings, into one of the most sacred and greatest places in England. Hope you've all enjoyed that. Take care, and thank you for watching.